project is to get this snowy scene in this incredible village in the Cotswolds called Castle Combe. But it's a challenge because there's lots of white in there, but also what is striking about this is the gold and the bright warm lights from that window there. I've got to get that, and I think there's a little bit of light here. Some brown Cotswoldy stone here, just poking out there, and keep it fairly muted in the background. I've got to get that kind of slightly greyed out. There's much less colour in objects when they're further away from you, much less chroma. And here, of course, we've got a lot of colour in the foreground, this window, some little browns and various things here. So we'll see how we can get along with that anyway. So I've sketched it out in a rough sort of way. Given me some sort of guidance, but my interpretation will be fairly loose. I'm not going to do it absolutely photo accurately, but I want to keep it fairly fluid and more impressionistic, really. So what we're going to do is give ourselves give it a good mop of water so we can get that sky in there, although it's not much blue up there. So we'll just dampen this off a little, let the water go into our paper, and then I need to get a little blue, very palish, wintry blue. So let me see, how am I going to do that? Get a little bit of just the merest hint of the blue, mix it in with some of the sort of ochre-y residue left on my palette there. So it's fairly neutral, sort of greyed out, steely colour. Can you see that? Where are we? Just there. So it'll be, yes, that looks pretty wintry. No, we're not going to get a suntan with that today. I'll just bring it down and leave it at that. And our foreground, I've got to get some ochre in our fairly warmish. This gets a little bit yellower than that. As we say, we'll definitely dry a lot lighter. So I'm gonna sort of sweep in just very loosely, I think, over this. It's gonna be fairly warm colour in our foreground there. And in the, I've got to preserve some of the whites, which is the challenge with a watercolour. Try and preserve as best you can some of the whites. This part of this building, it's got quite warm, relatively warm. And I say that will definitely dry a lot lighter. So there's a little band of honeys down there, honey coloured. I haven't got the bright sunshine, of course, to make it really zing, but we are in the middle of winter. Got the snow there. In the background, I've got a much darker building there. Coming down. Oh, background there. So I want a contrast with this snowy roof. So I've got to get some darks in there. And get some in this area. This is a little hedge, corn hedge and stones. I'll put in some more detail. I can leave some white showing. They can represent our snow. I think we need still a little darker variety of colours in here. Let it bleed through here. I'll put some dry brush strokes in later. Right. This wall has some slightly quite a bit darker, so drop a bit of blues into these. And that wall there by this, there's an entrance here. Get some just general wash at the moment. Now along here, some quite dark, got furniture all sitting out here. That's quite dark in here. Right. And inside this little passageway and under this archway, quite a distinctive feature on the darks in there. And in front of this house, we've got some hedges, get a bit darker here, and think, yes, something on that roof. Got to put something in there. Glaring white. I think I'm going to lift out these chimneys. On this base of this little dormer, very black. I think I can get some of our furs in. Some on the hillside here, there's these old fir trees, pretty well laden with the snow, so I'll leave those little bits of snow, a little bit of white from the paper. Now I need to put in some other a different tone in here to represent these trees in the background. So I've got to keep it. There is a little bit of colour there, so I'm going to go with a little brown, blue, and I think it's got a slight hint of red to it, so yes, let's go for that. I'll put some different textural marks into our house on the left here, but I think I will go on to a different brush in a moment. And the track that we have, the snowy track, we've got to try and get that as well. I know there's a lean, it's slightly bluey. some marks. This little slushy mark. Lots of footprints. Let's get something a little darker into that. Shadows come out here. As I say, that was quite dark in there. Coming in the background there. Get some more of our furs in here. Eve coming across there. I'm going to put some with a different brush shortly, but this will give me some cover, some of the tone on that, and then I sharpen up with a smaller one. Yes, I think I need to what am I going to do with this roof here? I'm going to keep it largely white. And this one as well. I think we'll just put some general marks to represent the tiles. Shadow coming down there. Generally in there is like that. Right. Now in our edges here, some vegetation, which is pretty much covered with the snow. think we need I can put some snow in, I suppose, with my gouache. I'll try to preserve the whites if I can. This door to this pub. Very dark. And a little doorway here as well. And we've got a few. It's too dark. Let's put a little colour in that front of that building there. We'll go to a smaller brush. I've got some more control. I think it's slightly rosy colour, but we can. Oh, knocking the camera. Let's go with something like that. I'm using the tooth of the paper to give me some textural here. What should I do with that? Front of this house. It's a bit greeny looking, I think. Got to darken this side gable end. I can get some more contrast with this. And there's a chimney there. Right. Some darks in for the dormers. Shape up these dormers a little bit. get these windows in. Hmm.